Well, hey there, team, and welcome back to the channel, and welcome to Pawnbarian. What a strange name. Look at this chat. He's big. Oh, his hammer is a pawn. Okay, I see. So, I've actually already been playing a little bit of this, and it's sort of a small-scale puzzle arena of chess, playing as a barbarian, though there are different unlocks. You can have the Pawnbarian. I've unlocked the Knight Templar, but I haven't tried him yet. And then you've got the Shogun as well. But I guess the titular dude is what we'll have a look at. It's a dungeon roguelike. It's fairly simple in concept, but, you know, in execution, it's very puzzly, very combo move. So you have to understand chess and how chess pieces move, which I don't know. I'm assuming this is common knowledge. Maybe knights people might not be able to get their head around so much, but essentially, well, actually, when you hover over the dudes, it shows you the move. So you move through this dungeon, you get like a little deck of cards, and it plays out from there. I'll explain as we go along the way. Like I said, I've been dabbling on it. I'm quite enjoying it. I'm not exactly a huge chess person, but I think this is a really clever implementation of it. So you can see here that he can promote pawns if you move into the top row, which is classic chess. If you start your turn in the top row, which kind of makes sense, and if you have three pawns in hand. Okay, this chain system, haven't unlocked that yet. Let's just embark. There is a tutorial section, the tutorial islands, which is pretty robust. I like these little bits of foley when I click on them, and I actually did beat this, the Goblin Caves, but, you know, this is a place to start out. We'll give it a bit of a burl. Okay. So that's me right there. These little red telegraphs are how many damage you're going to take. If you get lethal, it will actually be skulls. So seeing those helps. You can mouse over these little dudes, these capybaras or capybear or whatever you call them. This one's got a blight wake, so you can see the purple. He leaves essentially like a dot when he moves. This guy's just normal, but you can see this guy's a brawler type. He's a little bit more jacked. He's got some armor going on. And he's immune if I'm in a cardinally adjacent square, which is, you know, north, south, east, west. So as long as I'm not diagonal. So right now he's yellow, which indicates he's immune, right? So that gives you a bit of an idea of what you got to work with. You've got your gold up here and the red gem, which gets you a heart back, and you cash out whatever's left at the top when you clear the map. And you lose one gold each turn. So if you take too long, you don't get as much money, but you always get one heart back. What else? This is our deck, and these are special mutators that are on specific, well, I was gonna say cards, but pieces. You don't add cards to your deck, but you do get a chance at the shop after the level to mutate them. Anyway, how does this play? You get three cards here. These are the moves that you have. Your health that you have, your pawn. I can't use the pawn in this situation because he only moves forward and the dude in front of me is immune. So I can use the knight, right? And you only get two moves. That's not super clear at the beginning, but you only get two moves unless you pull a cantrip with a little lightning bolt. But look, let's just go with, I've only got two moves. You got to be careful what sort of situation you put yourself in here, right? So say I went, well, like, here's not really much of an option. I can't really get any kills. So I think what I'll actually do is go here. And I'll just go in turn. You can see there's my discard pile. In turn, discards my hand. They all get to move. Now let's see. Now cantrip, you can see, gives you an action and draw a card. So it basically cycles the deck. It replaces that card. And it also gives you an extra go. And so chaining cantrips, at least in my estimation, is a pretty good strategy. Pretty bold move, Cotton. Move one square forward or attack one square diagonally forward, right? So what we could do, we could actually hit that dude there and kill him. So let's do that, right? And then it drew up a new card. We've got another rook. And we've got two goes left. You know what we could do? We could go that. And we could kill him with the knight. And bang, clear. How cool was that? Nice. So we got some big dollary dudes. You can expand your health bar by one like that. This is the shop, right? At first it wasn't clear. You've between the queen and the knight, you can move freely to anywhere you want. This isn't really, you know, this is at your own pace. This is a shop, right? So for 10 bucks, what we can do is augment that card with a lightning bolt, and that's already pretty stacked. However, having one stack card's pretty cool, but I like the idea of spreading it out as much as possible. Well, I mean, it depends. Now see this one, Cardinal Splash. So after you move, it will damage in each adjacent cardinal area, and the shield will give you a one-off armor thing, like most sort of roguelikes, right? So it's handy to have both. I think the cantrips are king, to be honest. And I can afford that one. So let's just go up to there and buy that. We've only got a dollar left. We'll go to the next floor. Okay. Is it all making sense so far? It's pretty cool, actually. You get to memorize these little dudes. Their little icons remind me, here's a deep pool of Hero Quest, because I used to be the dungeon master on that, because I'm the nerd that organizes all the other nerds. This reminds me of all the pictures of the dudes that you'd have to place in the dungeon. Oh man, HeroQuest, I haven't thought about that in forever. So nimble. So for example, he's nimble. If I were to drop the knight on him, he will actively move away from that if he can, if it has room. Now, what dictates away, I suppose? Would it be the diagonal or up down? It's the diagonal, interesting. Probably favors the lead on the L. Now he's only moved that one time, so this is actually a good setup. We could use the pawn to kill him, right? So he essentially gets a get out of jail dodge one time, but then you have to hit him the second time. Blight blast, so when we kill this dude, he's gonna blight all the adjacent squares. And this dude's got the same story. They're both nimble, aren't they? All right. Now look at this, this is our super jacked card. We'll get Splash, which is not so helpful. Now pawns only move you onward and upward, never forward. So only so helpful. Nimble is not really gonna do the job there. Oh, actually, you know what? We could probably, let's go like that. And this should kill him because he'll dodge the attack, but the splash will then kill him. Yeah, that's what I thought. King's not gonna do anything, pawn either. I don't know, maybe we just do that. Okay, there you go, easy. Dumpster in one and then two, bang. Nice. So yeah, trying to juggle the economy is pretty king. Yeah, see the game knows, I've already figured it out. The game knows that the cantrip is where the party's at. So the more cantrips I put in my deck, the more you can chain moves. Let's see. Let's do that. Let's do that. I've still got one move. Let's just get out of here like that. Perfect. It starts to get a little bit more brain twisty, hey? Not a lot I can do here. Let's just end there. This is a safe square. Now this, you know what, this is worth experimenting with. Because he can't retreat, will he get crushed immediately? He will. Sucked in, you bloody goober. I've got two left. Perfect. There you go. Just gotta pay attention to the little yellow arrows there. $14 dues, eh? So I'm going a bit glass cannon. That's just my attitude in general when I play anything. We'll get by with the health. Well, famous last words. See, we've got three hits in here. Now, they're blighted. He's a brawler. Now, this is a vigilant. He's, well, the hero is not in any of the adjacent squares. Oh, so I have to kill, he's an inversion of the brawler. I have to kill him. Isn't that interesting? King. Well, this is a bit tricky, isn't it? Yeah, so we'll take one hit. Snake Packer. You gotta be careful. If you get stuck in a corner like this, you're in deep trouble. As much as, like, I could kill this, but he'll damage me. Let's just stay here for the moment. We don't talk about it. Talk about it. How do I manipulate the pawn into a good position? However, I will draw, won't I? Oh, you know what? I think I can see it. Potentially. And then splash him. Get out of here. Oh, man. God, I'm brilliant. Okay. Same thing again. I'm going for the lightning bolts. I've got $9 remainder. So... I mean, you'll do just fine, thank you, sir. And we got our health back as well. So the chance of getting lethal is getting much, much higher, right? Look at this, you know, they are definitely trying to kill me. That diagonal split. No, I can't. How do you work? Cardinally adjacent? Oh, look at that. Get bloody blasted. I've got two more moves left. What's your problem? He's the champion. You have to kill him last. I see. Oh, I've made a bit of a boo-boo here, haven't I? We'll just wait. Now, Wibbed, I believe, makes it so you can't have more than two cards in your hand. I'm not 100% on that one. Oh, bugger. You'll get yours, mate. So he, what is he? A goblin shaman. So he attacks all the outside rungs. That's cool. And he's got nimble. Fat lot of good it did him. All right. Now, I mean, continuing in the tradition of glass cannonry, let's get more splashes. The damage mitigation is probably a good idea, but bugger it. Let's just go all in. I've got so many damages. It's pretty crazy. Look at that. I'm in a safe spot here. It's my game to lose, isn't it? Oh, wow. Look at that. Whoa, no way. Oh, they couldn't get away. Sucked in, you bloody goobers. I might rip out to here. Give myself a bit of space. Yeah. Oh, he exploded when he died. Right, I have to be in an adjacent square. Got a king, got a rook. Oh yeah, okay, we can do that. We can work it out. Mate, look at this, Mr. Moneybags right here. 7 of 7, let's go. Look at this bloke. Blight caller. Spawn a blight sack on an empty adjacent square. So these things here. Blights all adjacent squares after death. Things are getting a bit hairy for our bloody hero. See a great way out of this. Alright, hang on, if I go to there and I could horsey to the corner if I needed. Ugh. Oh, it's getting too hairy in there for me. Let's get out of there. All this blight shit could go away, that'd be nice. Queen. Oh man, there's not a lot of safe spots left, is there? Risk it for the biscuit. I think blights all adjacent squares after death. That's poo. Oh, I had a shield that blocks. That's nice. King. Oh my goodness. I do have a shield. Oh, okay. Yep, we're good now. Cantrip. Oh, oh! Get out of here. Nice. Oh, that's satisfying. Now, I don't understand what this is. Exit. Rest on your laurels. Deeper parts of the dungeon are sealed off with ancient magic. Immune while other enemies are alive. Gauntlet pillar. Conquered. Right? So I can't interact with that. So I guess I gotta smash all these things. And then I can do that. And it puts me into the gauntlet, whatever this bloody is. So this is like a new game plus or something. Holy heck, we're straight into it, aren't we? Okay. Nice. See what I mean about training the cantrips? Now, I'm not saying that's the only way to play it. That's just what I figured out. What do I know? I'm just some idiot that plays video games. Now, what's your problem? Champion, and you're a brawler. Mongrel. Being in the corner is probably a terrible idea. Good way to get stuck. Oh, nice, because I got him with the diagonal. Get wrecked. Brawler. Brawler, brawler, brawler. Can I? There we go. Yeah, nice. You take one few steps back, one step forward. Oh, wow, we're going for it. No shot for me. This is just wave defense in a way, right? Gotta think about this. Really starting to cook the noodle, you know? Wait, are you kidding? Come on, game. There we go. Alright, let's go. I'm not done yet. Gauntlet floor 3. Chain 0. I don't know what that's about. How many guys are you going to put on the board, game? At a certain point, this is unfair. Can't stop me, baby. I'm really enjoying this game, eh? It is a brain twister. I can take the hit, I've got a shield. And what's your problem? I have to be next to you, don't I? Nice. Let's keep going. Let's let it ride. Goodness. Gentlemen, one at a time, please. A lot of archers in there. That's problematic.
shit.
Oh no, this might be the end for me, because I've only got one shield in my deck. Interesting, if you do want to run the gauntlet, you probably have to stack shields. Wow, that was pretty huge though. God, do I do it? Do I just dive on this? Oh no, you idiot, I misclicked. That was a bit silly. Bugger it, I'll just bail. Oh, I had a shield. I might have been able to do something magic there. Ah. Oh, this is the end. This is it. I can't get out of this. Oh, well, hey, you know what? That worked out. Made for a good episode. Gauntlet 4. Pretty cool. I guess you exit to the menu and then, you know, rinse and repeat. Got your different dudes to do. Knight Templar. No cantrips, but you get a cantrip whenever two knights are played in the same turn. Looks like his deck is stacked for knights. So that's pretty cool. And he's obviously big on the pawns and the shogun. Who can say? Who can say? Anyway, Pawnbarian. What a cool little game. Actually, quite addictive. I might have to play a bit more, I think. Yeah, you should check it out. It's on Steam at the moment. Team, might just leave it there for the time being. And I'll catch you guys on the next one.